So there's two AirFiber devices right now. There's the Jio AirFiber, which was announced at Reliance's AGM last year, but that hasn't arrived yet. And then there's the Airtel AirFiber, which is actually launched in India. And this is the AirFiber I've been testing. And this is actually interesting. I mean, this is the device right here. And if you ask me, initially, I really liked it because this has really nice speeds. It has a very nice portable design. It has Wi-Fi 6, which has its own advantages. But there is one catch here. Look, I'll get to the gadget, but the purpose of the AirFiber is to bring fiber-grade internet speeds to areas that don't have access to fiber connections. This can be rural areas where fiber connections just haven't reached yet. This can be mountains. This can even be in cities. For example, I stay in Noida, and still there are a few societies here that don't have fiber connections yet, and that's where this comes in. I mean, this is what the device looks like. It's got a nice star-like design, and I like the minimal all-white look. It's also smaller than I expected, which means it's very portable. It's got these LED indicators on the front. This is for internet status. This shows the network bars, and this shows if the Wi-Fi is ready or not. The top and the bottom here have these vents, although I heard no noise at all in my usage. The back has these ports and switches, a USB port, I'm guessing, for software updates, 4 Ethernet ports if you want to use it like a usual router, a reset button, and the power switch and port. On the bottom, you get the SIM card slot, which is easily accessible, but we tried a different Airtel SIM and it did not work. We also tried a Jio SIM, but obviously it did not work. Now, the best thing about this design is that unlike fiber connections, you don't have a ton of wires dangling around and you're not limited to a certain area to set up your router. This can just be plugged in anywhere and this will work. What's also nice is that the Airtel app shows you the best location for this to be set up, the location where this will bring the best speeds, and the speeds are actually good. See, this only has a 100 Mbps plan right now, and like all unlimited plans, this has a limit of 3.3 TB per month. Anyway, this relies on Airtel's 5G network, and our office does get 5G, so we tested things out, and the speed on the AirFiber were actually good. I mean, I tested the speeds on multiple devices, and I easily got over 100 Mbps on all of our speed tests. Now, do note that this is when the AirFiber has 5 devices connected to it, and these tests include tests done on different days for a better idea. If you ask me, these speeds are good. It's obviously not as good as, say, the fiber connection at home or 5G speeds from my phone, but this is pretty good for what it is aimed at. I mean, movies and shows stream at the best quality, web browsing is fast and nice, and I also played some games and I noticed the ping was good, so this is very good and this is also fairly affordable. We pay 2500 rupees as a security deposit for this device, and there's only one plan available right now, 799 rupees for 100 Mbps speeds, and you have to get it in a 6-month plan, so the total cost was ₹7,733. Now, one important thing to note here is that the 100 Mbps plan on the AirFiber costs ₹799 per month, which is identical to the 100 Mbps plan on the fiber connections. Yes, you don't have to pay a security deposit or any installation charges on fiber connections these days, but this has one advantage. This is a Wi-Fi 6 device. I mean, these are the advantages Wi-Fi 6 brings over Wi-Fi 5, but it's not the speed that matters, especially in India. It's the range that does. Wi-Fi 6 is set to theoretically bring almost double the range compared to Wi-Fi 5, and this was kind of handy in my testing. See, our office is on the second floor where the routers are set up, and for testing purposes, we went to the ground floor, but the Wi-Fi 5 router just wasn't available. The AirFiber Wi-Fi 6 router, on the other hand, is available, and it even works even if you move across the road. Yes, the speeds aren't the best, but the fact that this works so far away is just commendable. I mean, sure, you can get a Wi-Fi extender or a Wi-Fi 6 router which starts at ₹3,000, but that's again an added expense. Look, all of this is why I initially liked the AirFiber, but like I said at the start, there is one catch. See, this can be a good fiber replacement for areas which don't have fiber connections, only if that area has a good 5G network. To give you an idea, I took this device to my home where there's no 5G network yet, and I saw the network fluctuate quite a lot and the speeds were down. I got 24 Mbps in one test, 15 Mbps in another, yeah, not even close to 100 Mbps, and this is in a city. The AirFiber, as Airtel says, is aimed at fiber dark areas and to address last mile connectivity in rural and urban India, but right now I'm not so sure about that. Now, I know right now this device is only available in 2 cities in India, Delhi and Mumbai, and that's for a reason. These cities have a strong 5G network. I mean, Airtel is clearly testing waters right now, but one thing is for sure. For this to be actually useful, Airtel needs to have a good, speedy 5G network all across the country, especially in rural areas or mountains, which is where the device is aimed at. I mean, Airtel clearly mentions that it plans to launch the AirFiber in multiple cities and scale up nationally in a phased manner. So hopefully this will become more useful in the future. Look, I have a question for you guys. Do any of you live in an area where there's no fiber connection yet? If yes, do you think this or the Jio AirFiber can be useful? Make sure to share your thoughts in the comment section down below, and thanks for watching.